Yet another School Synergy workshop, and I am Ruchi Kumar, working at Center for Excellence in Teacher Education as an assistant professor, Tata Institute of Social Sciences, Mumbai, and I am the host for this School Synergy workshop series. We have been holding these workshops since 2000.
Ma'am, you are muted.
I'm so sorry. I was just speaking on while I was mute.
No, no, okay. We just were not able to hear the last line. Others, we were.
Okay. Yeah. So, okay. So we have been having this workshop, School Synergy workshop series, since 2018. And in 2018, we were having face-to-face workshops with nearby teachers who were interested. When pandemic happened, we moved this effort online. And we have been, since August 2019, we have been having these workshops every weekend from 3 to 4 p.m. We have a YouTube playlist of all the previous workshops from August 2019 onward. And we will share the link afterwards. You can have a look at it. I just wanted to explain all of you the objective of this School Synergy workshop series. We want to provide a platform where the university professionals who are engaged in teacher education, as well as teachers who are engaged in school practice, get a shared platform to share their ideas, to discuss resources that can be directly used in the teaching, to share their experiences of working with children, working with the student teachers, and to learn from each other. So it has been a really very enriching experience to talk to all the people who have been facilitating these workshops, and also to listen to all the teachers who have shared their ideas and experience on on this group itself, on this sessions itself. We also have a Telegram group in which around 300 people are already a member. And in that, this is called School Synergy Teachers Forum. And we continue our discussion beyond the session on that group itself. We discuss what was discussed in the session itself, the points that were discussed in the session. We discuss questions and ideas of how we can extend it to our own practice. So it has been very interesting for us to engage with all of you over these past few months. Today, I have with you my student, Chitra Kumari, who is a student in B.Ed. M.Ed. Integrated Program at the center itself. And we also have Brinda Rao, whom we are looking forward to listen about how to use first language for teaching and learning. I'm sure it's going to be a very interesting experience again. So I request Chitra to please introduce Brinda Rao ma'am to all of us.
Thank you, ma'am. Welcome everyone. Welcome Brinda ma'am. So Brinda ma'am provides support for the continuous professional development of teachers of Shri Krishna Vidya Kendra. Vidya Kendra, a rural school in Karnataka run by Ramakrishna Mission, Shivana Hali. She enjoys translating educational relevant literature from English to Kannada. So here I pass on to you, Vrinda ma'am. Welcome to the session. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Ruchi. Thank you, Chitra. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm really happy to be here having a discussion with you all. You know, I have been interested in Synergy for a long time. It's a pleasure to be with you all. So basically today I'm going to talk about using first language in English language teaching and learning, or any second language teaching and learning. And you know, when we're teaching a second language, how to use child's own language to support it. You know, there has been a shift in this regard. Earlier, you know, it was frowned upon. English, using any other language in an English classroom was absolutely frowned upon. It was more like you have to use that language, immerse children in that language. But there has been a shift for various reasons. I don't think we need to go to those reasons. But in this session, let's look at a few translation activities particularly, and have later have a discussion about this process of translation and what opportunities it can provide for language learning. So, you know, when we're learning language, we are interpreting, we are listening, we are doing everything. So I'll just have you all, I'm assuming only few of you are probably Kannada speakers and most of you are non-Kannada speakers. So I'm just going to read you something in Kannada and let me know what you think about it, what it is about, who it is about, and all of these things. Of course, Kannada speakers will know this anyway. Let me just start. Tattu chapale puttamagu, takko kai, ikko kai, Gandhi gindu janumadina, tattu chapale puttamagu. Tattu chapale puttamagu, mindu kaddar indu udu, Gandhi gondu huu idu, takko kai, ikko kai, ತಟ್ಟು ಚಪಾಳೆ ಪುಟ್ಟ ಮಗು ಆಡು ಹಾಲು ಹೆಸರು ಕೀರು ಬೇವು ಚಟ್ನಿ ಗೋಧಿ ರೊಟ್ಟಿ ಅಷ್ಟು ನೀರು ಅವನಿಗಿಡು ತಟ್ಟು ಚಪಾಳೆ ಪುಟ್ಟ ಮಗು ಇಂಡಿಯಾದ ಮಗುವು ಗಾಂಧಿ ಇಂಡಿಯಾದ ದೀಪ ಗಾಂಧಿ ಕಂಡು ಅವನ ಕುಣಿವ ಬಾರೋ ತಟ್ಟು ಚಪಾಳೆ ಪುಟ್ಟ ಮಗು. So I just want to ask you, what do you think it was about?
You can raise your hand, you can unmute and speak, you can type on chat also, however you feel comfortable. Some person say Gandhi Jayanti.
Something poem related to clap your hands.
Absolutely, yes. And Gandhi Jayanti, yes.
Someone said poem on food, kids and foods.
Yes.
And some said about India.
Yes.
Yeah.
The action, I was able to make it out, but I couldn't understand a single word.
It was absolutely like many people said, it was about Gandhi Jayanti, celebrating Gandhi Jayanti, having a child come over and celebrating Gandhi Jayanti, you know, giving him goat's milk and trying goat's milk and roti chutney and, you know, minimalistic kind of food. So this is absolutely what happens when we are trying to listen to another language. You would have interpreted based on the sound, the action, and some things that you knew and everything. So interpretation happens all the time, whether we're listening to, you know, a language that we know or a new language. In translation also, it's sort of an interpretation. You know, you are going to say that in your own language what you have interpreted as what you understood in the language, in the source language. So when I say use translation, I do not at all mean we use a lot of first language in the English classroom or do everything by way of translation. It's not like, you know, everything you're saying in Hindi or in Kannada or whatever. When we learn a new language, it is absolutely important to have what linguists call comprehensible input that has to be given to children. So we absolutely have to provide those inputs. You know, all the things that we know are important. There's plenty of English in English classrooms, lots of listening opportunities, stories, games, activities, all of these are absolutely essential. But what we do mean by translation activities is to give opportunity in something that interests learners, you know, something that they want to share, something that they can get involved in, and they'll put an effort into it. You know, as English teachers, we all know I work in rural schools and have worked with many government schools, it is very difficult for them to come out and say something original in English, you know, or to, when you give mixed sentences or for a paragraph to be written, it's very, very difficult. But these activities, we found out that, you know, children were a little more forthcoming. So again, to begin with, comprehensible input is absolutely important. I'm not taking that away from it. And some of us, you know, who have been doing this for a long time, even when we use first language when we, in English classrooms especially, when we think the communication is breaking down, you know, children are absolutely not understanding what we are saying. That is the only time we use it, and we use it with a little bit of hesitation. Because, you know, we have been, I guess, drilled that other languages shouldn't be used, whatever. So what I want to discuss is that children come with this rich knowledge of a language that they are familiar with. They know, without being conscious of it, they know the grammar structures. They know so many things about that language. And they have, what I've been seeing is also interest and motivation to, there is no dearth for that, to learn English especially. That is absolutely, I mean, every kid that I speak to wants to learn English, at least in the schools that I have seen. So I wanted to see if we give a little bit of space for their first language, if the child gets better in both of these languages. So that is the objective. So what I'm suggesting is to take up translation as a meaningful activity where child gets to negotiate in both languages. It provides for us to give tasks where children can choose. We'll see some of the tasks now, what they want to share, and let them use English words, make sentences in meaningful when they do it in a group, in a very non-threatening environment. And in all of this, when you're translating, meaning has to be at the center. You can only translate what you understand. So meaning will definitely be at the center of all this, which we want in language classrooms anyway. So thinking about meaning, so where can we start? I mean, what level can we start? Do you think it has to be, what I have been thinking and what I have been trying to do is to do it at all levels. So where can we start? Is we can start with our own names. I know Ruchi has a translatable name. I'm sorry. Does anybody else have translatable names that you want to share now? Either unmute and share, or in the chat box.
Because development.
Okay.
Smriti, dreams.
Okay.
Shivangi, beautiful.
Okay. So what we could do is, you know, when children come and we have make these labels, name tags, if children are okay with it, and also explaining to some children, and not all names are translatable, if children are okay with it, there is we could make a name tag with both of these. You know, it doesn't matter which script it is in, but there is an English name and there is their whatever name they have, their original name. So this will kind of very naturally add to their vocabulary. It's something that they connect with very easily. Going a little, extending it a little bit, the places, the names of the places around us, a lot of them have meanings that we don't pay attention to most of the times. You know, like in Bangalore, there's this place called Whitefield. And there is Kanakpura. Kanakpura is, Kanaka is gold and Pura is town. You know, and then so many, Jayanagar. Jayanagar is again a victory. And so maybe some of you can share, if you live any place, Gurgaon and Meghalaya, and all of these places have these Just yeah, but they can also add to these things, you know. It is if they can think of names where yes. they are teaching yeah. around that, you know, some names that
Munnar, they say Munnar Three Rivers.
Oh, okay.
Nice,
yeah. And this will, like, you know, immediately you get a sense of that place also. And children may even start thinking about it. Oh, when the town, place I live, you know, is called this. And in Bangalore, they might think, oh, this was a village before. You know, that kind of sense of where they are maybe going after the history or how the name came about. So it could very well turn into a UBS. Yeah.
So someone has said Manasa, her name is Mansa, and it's mind.
Yes.
Puttur, city of pearls.
Wow. Yes.
So children, Madhya Pradesh, it being a center, Madhya, it's in the center of the India, Madhya Pradesh.
Yes.
Okay. Kolkata, ground of Kali.
Ah. Yeah.
Okay, I didn't know it was like that. Really nice.
So these kind of instantly we can get to that, right? I mean, we connect to it, and children love to listen about themselves also, bringing attention to their names. You know, it's I think in and getting that translated and explaining some of these things would really be a fun, you know, bilingual. Approach for that we could have. And in the next activity, let us look at something different, you know. Not we all know, language teachers know, that the words don't carry all the meaning. So but then we have to focus a little bit more on the meaning to carry a translation work if we are going to get children to do this. Let me share my screen now. Just hold on. I have a few things that, you know, you can discuss for words and get into this activity of translating these sentences. Let me just share.
You share screen, click on the share screen, and then go to the tab that you want to show.
Do you see?
We can see. We can see. Great. Yeah.
Do you want to take a pen and a paper or type on your chat? How you will translate this? Maybe take a couple of minutes. I know it cannot be done instantly.
So this is in Hindi, and you can make an attempt of translating it. There are many people who I think who are there in the audience who knows Hindi. Can you just raise your hand? Who all knows Hindi? Can you all just raise your hand? Those who know Hindi.
Yeah, three people.
Okay. Okay, I can see around, yeah, there are quite a few. I think at least 15 to 20 people are there who know Hindi.
Oh, okay.
Rest can also make an attempt. It is changing actually, you know, the number. So there might be more people, in fact.
Okay. In the meantime, they can also start translating this, you know, any one of this or all of these.
Yeah, please unmute and try to translate. Shikha Pullave is saying, doing prayer and having bad intentions behind. For Muh Mein Ram, Bagal Mein Churi. Sam G says, for the first one, to say something good or nice, but have an evil intent.
Yes.
For the third one, Ram says, when one approach does not work, change it. So this is for jab seedhi ungli se ghee na nikle to ungli tedhi kar leni chahiye. Okay, Aarti Kachru says, evil in design, evil in, sorry, I just missed that. Evil in design and evil in thinking. Double profit for second one. Aam ke aam, gutliyon ke daam. Double profit.
Double profit.
Ma'am, may I for the second one?
Sure, yes. Sure. Please go ahead.
Aam ke aam, gutliyon ke daam is like, whatever is the main thing. From there, you are earning something, but you are earning from the wastage also. It's a kind of, if I give an example, a small example, in soya plants, the soya bean, from soya bean oil is removed and other products are also being produced. And from that, the wastage, that khali, they make soya buddies and they make some food for animals also. So it's like 100% they are getting from that product. So aam kya aam and gutliyon ke daam, what I understand.
Yeah, would you agree with the double profit, or you think it involves?
No, more? Not exactly double profit, but at least nothing like you can even the wastage from wastage, the waste from there also you can earn something. Okay. It's like that.
So it's a more expanded meaning than double profit, right?
Yes, yes, exactly.
Yes. Thank you.
Yeah, so we have got more response.
Ruchi, we cannot hear you.
Yeah, so this is nice. Trip 2 says, talking Tokyo, looking London.
Which is that? Nice.
I think it must be Muh Mein Ram Bagal Mein Churi.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, talking Tokyo, looking London. Yeah, nice.
Oh, okay.
Then one another person says, one thing on tongue and another thing in heart. Vikas Kavare. And then Chandrika Mathur says, someone who has pious words but engages in evil deeds. For the, again, Muh Mein Ram Bagal Mein Churi. And for the second one, two-way ticket for the price of one. And another interesting one for Muh Mein Ram Bagal Mein Churi is double-sided face. Yeah, and yes. For the second one, to make best use of even the throwaway waste. I think this is based on what we were talking just now. And for the second, another one by Khan Mehroz is more value for one's money. And then no waste, have the cake and eat it too. Wow, this is, I feel very apt, no? Have the cake and eat it too. I don't know. What do you all think?
Yes.
Returns from the fruits and also from the seeds. No loss. Getting multiple benefits or advantages. For the third, a straightforward approach doesn't work. Change your approach to manipulate. Change way of doing something. When one enjoys the fruit and there is no wastage. For the second one. For the first one, this is also very interesting. Duality in thought and action. Whether it is duality or whether it is something else, I don't know. Then keeping bad intention but speaking sweetly.
No, that is a Muh Mein Ram Bagal. Yes.
Yeah. So if in one simple way something doesn't get done, try a complex approach.
That is the
that is agar seedhi ungli se ghi na nikle to tedhi kar leni.
Yes.
I don't know whether it's a complex approach.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
This is Chandrika says, so you need strategy when the direct approach doesn't work. I feel this is quite apt. Then when something is not working in a simple way, change to manipulate it. Deviate from the rule to get one wants.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Good interpretation. Tricks work better in complex situations. Aarti says. Yeah. So really thankful for so many interesting responses that you have given. So for the second, somebody has given another Hindi phrase only. Chit bhi meri, pat bhi meri.
Oh.
Aam ke aam, gutliyon ke daam. So, chit bhi meri, pat bhi meri, from what I understand, is much more used in the situation when you are playing some sort of either a game or it's some sort of enmity between you. But aam ke aam, gutliyo ke dam is used perhaps more in situation where you are trying to make use of something or selling something. I think that is perhaps more of. For the third one, another interpretation, a bear, if bear eyes cannot see, use glasses.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So you make another way. I mean, I think somebody else said that, right?
Yeah. Okay. So over to you, Brinda.
Yeah, that was really wonderful. So, and imagine children trying to figure this out and working in groups and, you know, actually getting into the meaning of what it is said and the thinking of the context and the kind of discussions that can go on amongst children or, you know, among with a teacher and children, whatever. So this is, these are some of the things that we could use in the classrooms. And children keep hearing these such sayings. So we could probably have children bring this, to the classroom and then have them notice that words do not always carry the meaning. It is sometimes something else, and we say it in so many different ways. And we express things differently in different languages. These could be the exercises where children put their interpretive, how they can interpret these texts on their own and in their own language, and then get the main idea from that and then translate it into another language. So this is something that children can get to the classroom. Now, we tried something a little unconventional perhaps, but films, you know, that is something that children really like to talk about. I have had a few children that just wouldn't open up. They were from Tamil Nadu, and I think by chance one day we started talking about films, and this fellow was all telling me stories and everything. So this is where Bollywood helps us a lot, I think. I have another a couple of dialogues that I have translated into English. Maybe you people can guess where this is from. Let me just share this again. I have to share first, right? Yeah. The kind of response we got in school when we started using this was amazing. I'll just share that also a little later. You able to see? Are you able to see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes.
Yes, ma'am.
First one, that is a Minpur.
Oh, yes. Yes, absolutely. Sorry. This one?
I guess it is... there are three heroes, I forgot. Zindagi na milegi dobara. Oh.
Boy. I'm Gully Boy. Anyway. So what we did recently was we asked children to remember from, you know, from the stories they've read, the movies they've seen, drama, the only kind of things that no swear word, and it shouldn't offend anybody. So one of the dialogues that came about, and I just wanted to share this. In Kannada, this is a famous Kannada hero. and he says something like "Naan boravar matra berar hava, naan banmel nande hava." You know, that is the dialogue, which means people can say whatever they want to say. Hava is, you know, hava, right? I think so when they were trying to translate this, the amount of vocabulary that flew in the class, you know, for hava, what do we use? Do we use wind? Do we use climate? Do we use something else? You know, what do we do? And come, arrive, and all of these things. And they wanted to have a sentence that kind of, they wanted to sound like this fellow, Yash, also. So it was quite animated discussions that we had during that. And when they're doing it in, again, it was kind of difficult to contain their enthusiasm. So we had to tell, now, whatever you say, you have to translate. So you can't just say the story, you have to translate. So that is how much they want to share about this thing. So we could do the same thing with books also. If they read something and they like it, they bring that back to the classroom. This really kind of gave us a very good window for us to have children use English a lot more. And then what happened here was, here children, like I said, chose what they wanted to choose. And then they were communicating in both, like, you know, from Kannada and into Kannada. I mean, saying, oh, no, we have to use this word and that word. And hingandre hang, if you say this word, then that will mean something else and all these things. And they're also thinking, encouraged with very creatively, and they're thinking about the choice of words, which we had not seen earlier, the kind of words that they were trying to choose. We were not able to figure out that they had all this vocabulary, you know, sitting. They were also noticing differences in structures. So they're kind of paying more attention, more aware of both the languages, we felt. So now I think to get a little bit a better sense of what can be done in the classroom, Ruchi, can we get into the breakout?
Yes. So we can get into the breakout room. Let me just first tell you. So in the breakout room, what we are going to attempt is we are going to share one poem each in a breakout room, and you have to attempt to translate, engage in a collaborative translation together as a group. And so group 1, 2, 3, 4 would be Hindi, and 4, 5, 6 will be English. Okay, so I am going to share the links of all the documents, poem 1, 2, 3, 4 in Hindi and 4, 5, 6 English right now in the chat itself. Brinda, you can further explain about how they can collaboratively translate. Yeah. And then when I will open up the breakout room, each room, we are expecting around 10 people for 10 minutes. So yes, you can engage in that. We will move around different groups. If you are having any issues, you can ask for help also. There is a button, ask for help. You can ask for that. We will try to help you. And after 10 minutes, we'll come back and we will share our experience of the translating itself. Yes. So over to you, Brinda. I'll just share the links.
The only suggestion that I would have is you can translate only as much as you can. It's not so much about the product, I mean, what you get at the end of it. But, you know, whatever you're translating, have lots of discussions and take a little bit of creative liberties and try and translate mostly the messages like we did about with those proverbs there, and not so much about the words, but have the message translated with attention to what is in the source. And if there are people who speak other than Hindi, you know, I thought maybe they could have the choice to translate from English to any language that they want to and then share it also. And
even if you have a mixed group in those 10 people, if you have some sort of a mixed group, I would say don't worry, because the more number of different people from different languages are there, this aspect of translating itself will help you in able to communicate with the other person. So maybe that person can communicate, can translate to their language what it will mean, and you can try in yours, and you can share the words and see if they are similar or not. So just try, be with an open mind, try to engage in this experience. I have shared the poems, links of the 7 poems here. Now I'm going to make the breakout room. I am making 6 breakout rooms. So there will be around more than 10 people in one room.
Do you see the screen now?
Yeah, it's there.
Ah, okay. Yeah. So this is the poem.
Okay.
Do one of you want to read it out aloud and then discuss about how you want to? Maybe once read the whole poem out.
So I am trying, right? May I try?
Yes, please. Yes.
Hand pump par sher. Hand pump par khara hua tha ek sunahara sher. मारे प्यास के सिकुड़ गया था उसका लंबा पेट. यहां पे आया टिड्डा ज्यों ही दिखा वो प्यारा शेर, या जो धक्का पंप से निकला पानी तीनक शेर, या जो पानी मोटा हो गया उसका लंबा पेट, फिर भी यारो टिड्डे के संग उड़ा सुनहरा शेर. रिटन बाय सुबीर शुक्ला.
Okay, so how would you start translating this?
If I didn't know the meaning of sher, I would say lion on a hand pump.
Okay. All of you can unmute and start speaking like we're speaking in a group instead of muting and unmuting and all that. Like it would happen in if we were face to face. Can all of you please unmute?
Yeah, we have done it, ma'am.
Okay. Do all of you speak Hindi?
Yeah, we do. I especially. Yeah, I'm from Rajasthan, now in Punjab. I'm just, I can speak all 3 languages.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think title is good. Lion on hand pump.
Okay.
Hand pump. We can't translate the hand pump. I think there might be some different words for hand pump in English. But
I don't think so. Is it, Brinda ma'am?
What?
Hand pump, a different name for hand pump. I don't think so. Hand pump is called hand pump in English only. Or any other name?
No, hand pump is called, this.
I think English only.
Yeah, that is English only.
Yeah.
But it was hand pump. We can reuse that hand pump. Okay. Yeah.
So it's okay. We will go with that title.
Okay.
Lion on the hand pump. Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Now we have to translate the whole poem into English, ma'am.
However much, maybe we could take the first verse first. Okay. The first 5 lines.
Okay.
And then discuss how you want to do it, whether you want to just do it as line by line or take the whole thing, discuss the meaning, and then see how you want to put it, how you want to present, what kind of word we use and all that. So what is the meaning of the first few lines? My Hindi is very shaky. Okay, I only know movie Hindi. I study language. You will have to teach me.
We can try.
Yes. So you will have to do this. I'm going to be an observer.
Okay.
And everybody can discuss, you know, whether what she's saying is something, or you have a different word for it. So hand pump we discuss, and it's hand pump is going to be hand pump, right?
Hand pump only, yeah.
Okay. Hand pump par khada hua tha ek sunhara sher.
Sunhara sher.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you could see a golden lion was standing on a hand pump.
Okay.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely right. Yeah.
And then?
Due to thirst, he was shrinked, no?
No. His long stomach was shrink due to...
Yeah. Right.
Because of thirst.
Long stomach was shrink due to thirst.
Yes.
Okay.
Is it, Ram sir, is it okay?
Oh, yes, ma'am, of course.
Yeah. Then we'll go to some next lines. Is it okay?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Is it okay with everyone else? Mamata, Mamata R, and Himbeshwar Sharma. Is that okay?
Yeah, it seems okay.
Okay.
Five lines. Now we have done with the five lines.
That's right. We'll just move to the second.
Then we'll now, shall we go to the next five?
Huh.
Okay. So this is how we want to say it, like a verse, or you don't want to see how else you can you can make it a poem. Do you want to make it a poem, or you just want to just give the meaning, like
translate,
just translate, and you know, just give the meaning of it?
We should try to translate in the poem also, because in different format now it would not be very much helpful, because a poem should be like a poem.
Okay.
Yeah. So rhythm should be there.
Rhythm should be. So we'll stick to the four lines, for these five lines then.
Okay. Yeah.
So just
I'm trying.
Yeah. I'm trying. May I try?
Yes. Yeah. Sure. Ramsar.
Okay.
Ramsar only.
So, Lion on a Hand Pump, it will be title. And we may start that. There was a golden lion standing on hand pump. So these two lines we may see like that.
Okay.
And then for next... three lines, we'll just I'm organizing in a rhythm that how can we recite. But first two lines, we may start that. There was a golden lion standing on hand pump.
Okay.
Long stomach was shrink due to thrust.
Okay. Long stomach shrunk, we can say?
Yeah.
Shrunk, yeah.
Okay, shrunk due to?
Thirst. As you are thirsty, yeah. As you are thirsty, yeah.
Should we put the thirst first? There was a golden lion standing on the hand pump.
I could try this again.
Standing.
Yeah.
Standing on the hand pump, there was one golden lion.
Okay.
Due to thirst, had shrunk his long stomach.
Okay. Due to thirst, his stomach shrunk.
Long stomach.
Yeah. Okay.
Of course, it doesn't become rhyming.
Is that okay with everyone?
Yeah.
Anybody else has any other suggestions? Okay, then we go to the next one. Okay, the next five lines. Hello?
I don't know the meaning of the word tidda, but I can read this. Vahan pe aya tidda jyo hi, dikha wo pyara sher, diya jo dhakka pump se nikla, pani teene ek sher. I don't know what tidda means and what teene ek means. Or
what?
Even sher. I don't know the meaning of the words tidda, Tinek and Seer.
English word for tidda, no? It's an insect.
I try. So tidda means grasshopper, right?
Yeah, grasshopper.
So tidda means grasshopper. And tinek seer means, three liter. Because in Hindi, this is a poem written in some local words also. So tinek means three. and sayer is the measuring unit. So yes. 3 liter we may proceed.
Yes, yes, yes.
So here we can say that as grasshopper came there, dikha wo pyara sher, right? As grasshopper came there, lovely lion was there. Dikha means dikha to see or visualize something, na?
Was seen.
Was?
Was seen.
Was seen. Huh. Okay. As grasshopper came there, lovely lion was seen.
Mm-hmm.
As he pushed to hand pump, water came 3 liter. 3 liter water came something.
Okay, okay. So we could say a lot of water came. You know, we don't need, really need to stick to the three. It's just
no three. I'm sure that pani 3x share means 3 liter water came out.
Yeah, yeah. The word.
Yeah, yeah. But we can change.
Yeah, we can change a little bit and say.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Water just gushed out or something like that. Is that okay?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, okay.
Okay. And then the last one. Piya jo pani mota ho gaya, kala ho gaya.
After drinking water, stomach became.
फिर भी यार वो ठिड्डे के मेरा शेयर ब्रिंदा शुड आई क्लोज द रूम नाउ और डू यू थिंक वी शुड स्पेंड मोर टाइम बट इट्स ऑलरेडी ऑलमोस्ट टाइम राइट सो आई थिंक वी कुड व्हाट एवर दे डन वी कुड शेयर या या आई थिंक लेट्स डिस्कस एंड इट्स ओके वी एक्सटेंडेड फॉर सम टाइम Yes, yes. We could just discuss about the process and what happened. Yeah, yeah. Okay. So I'm closing the rooms. Okay. Yeah. They will come back in a minute. You can continue. Yeah. So we could finish the last. Oh, I stopped sharing. I think everyone was very engaged. I went into the rooms. They were doing it. They had selected a poem and there was quite an animated conversation happening in the breakout room, actually. That's nice. Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
There I think room 5 has already come back. I think room 5 had Asavari, Rachita, Reena Mishra, Sultana, yes, Suruti. Yeah, so would you like to share what you did there? Yeah, I think you came back first.
Yes. Yes.
Please share.
Yeah, please. I would like to read out. I'm Ritu Lakhan Pal. Can I start reading out my poem which you've translated in Hindi?
Sure, yes. Sure.
या सो इट सेज पैरों तले आग है आसमां के ऊपर भी आग है यू वांट मी टू स्पीक इंग्लिश एज वेल एज हिंदी और ओनली हिंदी वुड डू मैम
इंग्लिश एज वेल एज हिंदी बिकॉज
ओके ऑलराइट आई विल डू टू लाइंस एट अ टाइम मैम फायर अंडर फुटफॉल फायर ओवर स्काइज पैरों तले आग है आसमां के ऊपर भी आग है फायर ऑन अ मैचस्टिक फायर इन माई आईज माचिस की तीली में आग है मेरी आंखों में भी आग है फायर होल्डिंग हंगर फायर सीकिंग वुड भूख लगने में आग है काठ में भी आग है फायर हाइडिंग डेंजर फायर फीलिंग गुड खतरों में छिपी आग है अच्छे एहसास में भी आग है फायर एज द एनिमी फायर एक्टिंग फ्रेंड दुश्मन की जैसी आग है दोस्ती के जैसी भी आग है फायर आई मस्ट स्टैम्प ऑन फायर आई मस्ट टेंड आग को मुझे बुझाना है आग को जलाए भी रखना है fire in the embers, fire at the heart. Angaro mein aag hai, hriday mein bhi aag hai. Fires to remember, fires yet to start. Yaadon mein aag hai, par phir bhi aag abhi lagni baki hai. Thank you.
Thank you.
Ma'am, room two is ready with two paragraphs. We couldn't do the third one. We were doing it, but we came back to the session.
Okay. Please go ahead. It's okay. Whatever you have done, you can share.
I don't have the Hindi poem with me. It was the hand pump per share.
Okay.
So,
I have the Hindi with me. I can tell the Hindi and you can tell the English part.
Yes. So just recite the first paragraph.
Yeah. Hand pump per share. हैंड पंप पर खड़ा हुआ था एक सुनहरा शेर मारे प्यास के सिकुड़ गया था उसका लंबा पेट.
आई एम दिव्या फ्रॉम चंडीगढ़ फ्रॉम रितु लखनपाल मैम्स स्कूल. आई मैम.
हाय दिव्या.
ओके सो द टाइटल लायन ऑन हैंड पंप एंड द फर्स्ट स्टैंजा वाज अ गोल्डन लायन स्टैंडिंग ऑन द हैंड पंप ही वाज थर्स्टी एंड हिज लॉन्ग स्टमक हैड श्रंक. ओके या सेकंड पैराग्राफ.
यस वहां पे आया टिड्डा ज्यों ही दिखा वो प्यारा शेर दिया जो धक्का पंप से निकला पानी तिनक तिनेक शेर.
ऑन सीइंग द लवली लायन देयर केम अ ग्रास हॉपर ही गेव अ लिटिल पुश एंड केम आउट लॉट्स ऑफ वाटर. सो दैट्स व्हाट वी कुड डू.
यस इन आवर yeah, it was just two that we were able to make. But I think the focus is more on the process, you know, what happened. Let us just think, you know, maybe you can tell.
When we were discussing, you know, each one of us was coming out with the ideas and then we would write one line and it couldn't rhyme and then somebody would give another idea and then we would change and finally, you know, we were able to compose. So a lot of interaction and it was fun.
Okay, yes.
And the best part is we don't know each other at all, but yet we managed to collaborate so well. And we were able to be on the same page together. It was really nice to collaborate with people.
Yes.
Yeah.
And what happened with the way you noticed, this is a very personal experience for me. Because I translate quite a bit. I translate for Azim Premji University a lot of educational materials. When I look at something, even when as I'm reading something that needs to be translated, the way I read it itself is very, very different. You know, there's more attention is paid, not just for the meaning, it is also for how it is said. You know, you want to get the tone right, so you start noticing the structure a lot more when you're translating. And and for children also, you know, they will be so much of time we spend trying to tell them, you know, I and me and all these things. Some of these things just will be part of it when they're translating because their peers will be saying, and no, let's not use head shrink, you know, let's use shrunk, let's use this, let's use that word and things like that. So that paying attention to the structure along with the meaning and making sense. Oh, in Kannada, if we say we're going to say this first, but in English, you know, we're going to say this later, we're going to put it at the end, things like that. This yes. kind of paying attention to the language.
Can I say something?
Yes, please.
I was in group 4 and we were looking not for literal translations. We tried to look for the context and looking for the, maybe we're not able to choose right words in that context, but we will really focus on the meaning of in that context, what was the meaning in that context. So our collaborative effort was looking for the meaning in a particular context so that it gets in alignment with the thought of the poem. That was our effort.
That's wonderful. Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. So Sukesh Mukherjee says sense should come rather than go to word to word, and language we have to follow the poetic way.
Yes, in group number two, like we tried to follow a rhyming sort of scheme, you know, so we were trying it was the lion and shrunk and grasshopper and water. So we were trying to get a rhyming scheme into it.
Yeah, so looking at the language more closely, they were saying and thinking more deeply about the meaning other than just the surface level meaning, you know, you start thinking more about it. And then for children also thinking about the choice of words. And sometimes when you have more time, I mean, we with so little time, you all did so much. I mean, we can give a little bit more time and it be, you will start thinking about, you know, how else am I going to say this? And
In an abstract manner or, you know, more deeper meaning to it.
Exactly.
I mean, this poem, it ends with the lion flying away with the grasshopper.
Yes.
So, I mean, obviously there is a deeper meaning to it.
Yes.
It could be emotions, it could be your thought process, it could be chanchal man and whatever.
Right. Yeah. So, and what happens when they're doing this, when children are doing it in groups, they're more focused on what they want to say, you know, rather than how they're going to, because that is going to come later. They're not going to present it right away. So it's going to be more focused on what they're going to say. So that is quite difficult, especially when you want them to do it in a second language. You know, having them to focus so much on what they're saying and coming out with their own sentences. And a lot of times when it is something that they want to do, they work independently of the teacher also, you know, and we have in, when we're doing the translation, when we give these tasks, we have a lot of choice that we can give them, you know, we could have them choose what they want to do. Maybe it could be from the library period, it could be from what they've heard at home, it could be from
the languages, ma'am, teaching languages to them.
Yes. Yeah. And if you have a question on whether, you know, am I covering portions, I was just trying to map to what the learning indicators say, and in learning indicators, we have these indicators of understanding the main idea, locating the details in the text, seen and unseen, understands the purpose and characteristics of material other than textbooks, understands the form and functions of grammar in context. So I felt all of these things can be done with these kinds of activities where we can facilitate comprehension through various texts, facilitating children to locate details and sequence of idea, and then facilitating children to relate ideas of the text with personal experience through questions and discussions. When they're doing all these things that they bring from their own experiences, and learning indicators also indicate that we should introduce sources from L1 and L2 to facilitate comprehension. So, we are actually doing as teachers, I know we're all thinking about that also all the time. You know, are we doing covering our portions? I mean, a lot of these indicators can be covered through translation activities. So if you have any questions, I had a couple of more things, but I think we could use technology. You know, that is something that I think it's probably very little time that we have. Google comes out with some absurd translations. So if you give that to children, they're going to have fun looking at it. And then they're going to correct it. And you could, and then there are some beautiful dictionaries. Oh, that is one thing that I wanted to tell, that children, actually have a purpose to look for dictionaries. You know, it is something that they want to tell. They want to tell in English. It is their word. I mean, it is from the movie dialogue that they have selected. So they want to say that in English. So they come to you asking, how do I say this? You know, you.
So in the meanwhile, I think what she was talking about, that how you can use dictionaries also to aid these translation activities. As and because the kids have selected their own movie dialogue, they are very motivated to translate this, and they will come to you and ask you how one can translate this. So just wanted to ask if working with the students, have you ever had the opportunity of using translations? And if yes, then what is your experience? Do you feel it helps students in learning languages? And by that, I mean both English and Hindi. So if you're translating from English to Hindi or Hindi to English, is it helping you to learn only one language, or is it helping you to learn both the language, Hindi as well as English? Because many people, they fear that, if you use Hindi in English classrooms, perhaps students will not be able to learn English well. So just wanted to know from your experience. Okay, so there are some chat. Rohit says that what is the appropriate method of using prose in bilingual mode or translingual mode? So I think Brinda is back, we will ask her that. And April says he has not used. Okay, so there is a question also, Brinda. The question is, what is the appropriate method of using prose in bilingual or translingual? I think I'll repeat. There is a question. What is the appropriate method to use this bilingual or trilingual mode for prose, for learning prose? Did you get me?
Yes. I'd say that when we are trying to speak, I would still use English, a lot of English in different ways of, I started earlier, the comprehensible input still should be given to them. But these kinds of activities, giving a higher class child or a group of children, fifth grade children, to translate a story for standard or second standard would be really nice. I mean, that would give them a purpose to do it also. And then what we have done when we translate is, if it is an English book, you're able to hear me, right? Are you able to? Okay. If we translate into Kannada, we have these stickers that we put. If we have multiple copies of English books, we just paste it on the English text, the Kannada text. So, you know, the older class children know that their translation is getting used in the lower classes. So yeah, that, but for explanations and other things, I think it still be a good idea for us to speak a lot of English in the classroom, because a lot of times that is the only place that they are listening to the language.
Yeah. So Malvika Jha is asking, what age group are we looking here for these activities? Is it for more appropriate for a primary section, or should we use it with higher level students?
We could use it for higher, from primary to higher. I think it could be used different kinds of activities. Yeah.
Even I feel that it is appropriate, because we feel that maybe higher secondary or secondary students, they know the language. But it really helps them a lot in understanding something more deeply. If you are doing it in double language or as many multilingual languages. And in fact, in NCF 2005, there has been discussion about how to use different languages of students as a resource in the classroom. And I think this is one of the wonderful ways in which one can use the resource if students engage in these translating activities and learn from each other languages.
Yeah, actually I was asking, I completely agree with you, Ruchi. And what my experience has been that when we are asking children to use dictionaries, in the classroom, it really generates a certain kind of curiosity, and they really engage actually themselves. But at a certain age group, they are able to use dictionaries. So that's why I asked that question. Yeah, thanks.
Thank you, Malika. So Sam G from Cameron Tree School is asking, they don't use translation, but they do show movies without dialogues, and they ask children to express in their own language. So Brinda, do you want to comment on that?
Yeah, that would be a very nice way of interpretations also, right? And the use of resources that they have, the first language, and that is a... And this, again, when we are thinking of higher classes and translations, for them, if they're exposed to a lot of podcasts and all those, that is another challenge for those who are really interested to translate captions, for closed captions, for TED and these people, where there are lots of opportunities also to do, Ruchi.
If there are no more questions, I would like again invite Chitra to thank Brinda Rao, and also to share the feedback form link and the YouTube link that we have.
Sure. Thank you, Brinda ma'am. This last hour has been an enlightening journey for all of us. It was very enriching to know about the process of translation, thinking of the context, dwelling in it, and discussing that can follow from such process, poem or text can really help children in the classroom. The first-hand exposure to this activity must have given teachers a way in which they can make this a practice for the students. In the end, I would like to reiterate our deepest gratitude from the Center of Excellence in Teacher Education and Tata Institute of Social Science, Mumbai, to have you graced us with your presence this afternoon. I would also like to thank my faculty, and along with all the attendees, thank you, all of you, for being here this afternoon. Thank you, ma'am, and have a good day, all of you. Please fill the feedback form. The link is here.
Thank you, everybody. It was really very nice interacting.
Thank you.